Memorizing these vital signs is not important, but I bring it up to remind you that in pediatrics, we have the unique problem of needing to know what is a normal heart rate, a normal respiratory rate, and a normal blood pressure for infants and children, as these numbers change as we get older. So younger infants generally have a higher heart rate and respiratory rate and a lower blood pressure as a normal value than older kids. Remember, airway, breathing, circulation, this is where you're going to get a lot of that information, and having a sense of what are normal values is important. So spend some time looking this chart over as you're familiarizing yourself with vital signs in children. So what are the things we need to do? A patient comes in with shock. Generally, the first thing we need to do is support that circulation. So obviously, if there's an obstructive shock, before we're giving IV fluids, we need to do an emergent fix of the obstruction. So for example, in a tension pneumothorax, before we're giving IV fluids, we really need to do a needle compression. And you can check how to do that in our tension pneumothorax lecture. After those immediate interventions, we typically would give boluses. And the amount of bolus is 20 cc's per kilo. You should memorize that number. And we usually give that over 20 minutes, though you can certainly give it faster in a patient with acute hypovolemic shock. We may repeat these boluses up to usually once, sometimes twice, rarely three times. By the time you're giving a fourth bolus, you're probably making a mistake. These patients now probably aren't that dehydrated or hypovolemic unless there's ongoing losses. And you might consider another approach towards maintaining a higher pressure. The reason being is you can actually fluid overload someone who is in shock. And if you fluid overload them, the lungs become filled with fluid, and it can be harder to engage in a resuscitation in terms of the acid-base status with the breathing. So you don't want to make things worse. So after three boluses, you should start to think about alternative methods for maintaining blood pressure support. So what are those? Well, generally in children, we start with dopamine. So dopamine has both beta-1 and beta-2 effects, and it is a first-line pressor-supportive drug for children. It increases also cardiac output, which can't hurt, and it increases the systemic vascular resistance. Other options include for anaphylactic shock, we'll give epinephrine. We sometimes give norepinephrine for a warm distributive shock, though norepinephrine is rarely a first-line agent for blood pressure support, and for cardiogenic shock, we may give dobutamine. Sometimes we're not sure what's going on before the dopamine is already on board, and then we can switch agents. So that's my review of the management of shock in children. Thanks for your attention.